It's a small change with the hope it'll have a big impact. The Prime Minister altering the national anthem to make us one and free rather than young and free. And while it was done to recognise our Indigenous history, some Indigenous Australians say it doesn't go far enough.
From Australia Day to our biggest sporting stages. This is gone in place of this.
For we are one and free.
To recognise a 60,000-year Indigenous history.
We live in a timeless land of ancient First Nations peoples.
It's a very optimistic approach.
From Cathy Freeman, what a way to start the year. A phone call from our Prime Minister. We are one and free. Thank you. And on the new dawn of a new year, the Prime Minister hopes it's a message of unity.
It's a change for all Australians.
I think it's probably the right time now. We've had to mature a bit as a nation.
The change, recommended by the Prime Minister and ticked off by the Governor-General, was pushed for by the New South Wales Premier.
I'm incredibly proud of that change.
It's the first change since 1984. Bob Hawke was Prime Minister. But Advance Australia Fair was penned back in 1878 by Scottish-born composer Peter Dodds McCormick. It wasn't the anthem until 1973, briefly replaced by God Save the Queen before being reinstated.
Labor says today's lyric change is welcome, but it doesn't close gaps on Indigenous health and education. It wants a voice enshrined in the Constitution, and the government is close to announcing how the views of Indigenous Australians will be better heard.
What people want, clearly, is constitutional recognition.
As for the anthem, the first official performance could be next week at the cricket. Today, though, crickets.
Can we get a rendition of the new version?
My voice is extra croaky this time of day, so I won't do the rendition.
Singing by Prime Ministers is the same as with public exercise by Prime Ministers. It's best done in private.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.